Hello everyone, warm welcome to your decoding of the Economic Times newspaper. I am Priyanka Bhatia from Women on Wealth, and we are committed as a Women on Wealth community that women will be financially educated in this country and outside, and that they will take charge of their finances. Often a lot of women do not read the business newspapers, finance newspapers, because they think it's complicated, it's not for them. And the key is that if women want to really take charge of their finances, then they become comfortable in reading the finance and the business news. So that's the commitment inside of which we've been running various episodes of the Economic Times Decoding. Hey Ridhima, Sharda, Kavleen, Vedashri, Sapna, welcome everyone. Rohini, awesome. I am glad we are all ready to educate ourselves and move beyond. So, well, this is how the Economic Times look today. And let's begin with the first news, and that's right on the front page. And that is around how the newspaper is saying that startups are going to move from Gurgaon either into Delhi, Noida, Greater Noida, because that's like the closest, or it can move to Bangalore. So Bangalore, like all of us know, is the hub for startups. Most startups in our country are in Bangalore, and Delhi NCR has enjoyed the number two position for quite some time. So the paper today is talking about how companies might be shifting from this Delhi NCR region into either Delhi or the other side of Noida, Greater Noida. So that's what is in the papers. Let's read this through, because these are all the changes which are showing up in our environment, and we need to be able to decode this information so that we can see what's the future ahead. Note, guys, that yes, we judge the past performance of companies, mutual funds, other investments to identify if these are good enough to buy into. But actually, their performance for our growth of money lies in the future. So that's the most critical part. So we need to keep our eye into the future so that we can navigate well and reach our goals. So let's begin. Yes, Anusha, Shivani, Archana, warm welcome everyone. So the startup community based in Haryana, particularly Gurgaon, has been unnerved by the new law reserving 75% of private sector jobs that pay up to 50,000 rupees per month for those domiciled in the state. So this is a new law that Haryana has passed, and well, this is, it seems from this newspaper report that this law is going against what they're actually seeking. What they're seeking is more employment for their people. But well, if there'll be such a law, then yes, startups will move, because they want to have talent and they don't want to get restricted by people living in a certain state. So, you know, this is like a reservation. And of course, I don't think so startups can afford it, because I also run one and I know how it feels. So many new age companies, including startups, may have to consider relocating operations. And this is according to NASSCOM. NASSCOM is the industry body, guys. And this is Association of Software and Services Companies. So also, this the same thing is said by staffing firms like Quess and Xfino. I think they pronounce themselves as Xfino. I'm not sure. So startups see Noida, Greater Noida and Delhi as the best bet if they don't want to move too far away. Bangalore has the largest number of startups and unicorns in India and may attract more from Haryana. Delhi NCR follows Bangalore in having the second largest number of startups, unicorns and sunicorns. And most of them, many of them located in Gurgaon. So you guys can notice how one law can change things. So if you are investing, say, in businesses, in startups, one law comes and an action is taken accordingly. So, you know, this is, you know, how I was decoding this, that yes, I'm invested in so many businesses and businesses are so dynamic. So we can't be rigid about things in life. We got to see what's coming along. Does it work for us? Not work for us? If it doesn't work for us, move on, move out, whatever be the best decision at that point. Only in hindsight you will say, okay, was this a great decision, not a great decision? But well, this is how it truly works on the ground, when you are actually working on the ground and looking at the situation. So that's the key. So there is a survey done, and out of 80 Indian-based companies in the unicorn and soonicorn space, 12 are in Gurgaon. So 12 out of 80 is a big number, and there's about 9.6%. So them moving is going to be a big move for Haryana particularly. So yeah, that's how it is. These 80 companies employ 2,20,000 people across India. 11,000 are employed in Gurgaon. Half of them are non-locals. So well, that's pretty much defines it, right? Because if half of them are non-locals, then you got to increase. Say you're at 50% with locals, then you got to increase it from 50 to 75. And do you really need such people? And do they have the skills which will build the business, not build the business? So there are a lot of questions which any startup or business will be dealing with. So yes, so if you notice what I'm coming to decoding this information is, okay, businesses are dynamic. Are we willing to remain updated about the growing economy, the growing changes, and then adapt to those changes, make the moves accordingly? Because that's the key, and you will notice that most of this is a part of the mindset building. Not so much knowledge is required into this, but it's more mindset. And can I build the mindset? Am I willing? Karishma, Hira, welcome. Okay, rhythmized writing seems like a wrong move by the Haryana government. This law will adversely affect other sectors of Gurgaon, especially commercial real estate, and eventually leading to residential real estate. Yeah, I mean, of course, I don't think so. If anybody's office is moving to Noida, they're going to take up a residential property on rent in Gurgaon. I think it will be very, very unlikely that happens. So yes, Ridhima, bang on. Prachi, Namita, Kavneet, good morning everyone. So guys, this is one article that I wanted to talk about. Bring your focus to, because most of these companies, if you notice, the 12 companies which are being talked about in Gurgaon, they are mostly tech companies. And tech is booming right now, so I really don't see how this is going to work for startups. Okay, let's go to some fun news also. I think this is the fun news which all of us must know. So actor Akshay Kumar is the most visible celebrity endorser, everyone, in pandemic hit 2020. He's outpaced Indian cricket captain Virat Kohli by a good margin. So well, we all know when everybody was sitting at home to deal with the coronavirus crisis, there was quite news that Akshay Kumar is going out and shooting all these ads for brands. So this has been further authenticated now, is how it seems to me. So most visible endorsers, number one is Akshay Kumar, number two is Virat Kohli, number three is Kareena Kapoor, and number four is Ranveer Singh. So this is the fun part, and celebrity couples are number one, Anushka Sharma, Virat Kohli. Here Akshay Kumar is getting number two, Twinkle Khanna and Akshay Kumar. Three is Deepika Padukone and Ranveer Singh, and fourth are Kareena Kapoor and Saif Ali Khan. I don't know how many of you know, but I am really a fan of all this Bollywood news. So I always keep all this information in notice, because I think this is fun for me and I love reading it. Every day before sleeping, I go over a lot of Bollywood news to see what all is happening in Bollywood. It's my favorite thing to do. I trust some of you like Bollywood, like me. Okay, the last news for today, everyone. And that is indices falling for the fifth straight day. So stock market has been falling. Fifth straight day, stock market has only been falling. And the Sensex has fallen 1.2% or 585 points. And it has closed at 49,216 yesterday. Nifty dropped 1.1% or 163 points to end at 14,557. And today Nifty has fallen further. I mean, that's what I saw before I came for the decoding. So that all is happening. I'm going to read one important paragraph from here, and it is around foreign portfolio investors. So foreign portfolio investors, FPIs, net bought shares worth 1258 crore on Thursday. So they've been buying and domestic peers have been selling. And we all know when foreign investors buy, the market always goes up. And this has been happening continuously for the past five sessions. So overseas investors have continued pumping money into local equities despite surging bond yields. In the past five sessions, which means in the past 5 days, trading days, when the market fell, they have bought to the tune of 14,000 crore. So 14,000 crore bought, okay? 14,000 crore worth of stocks are bought by foreign portfolio investors, which include purchases through block deals as well. So far in March, these investors have put close to 22,000 crore into stocks here after investing 21,900 in February. So already, what, it is the 19th of the month, they've already surpassed the amount they invested in February. So which informs us that they're really, really being bullish in our market. While everybody else is selling, they are the buyers in the market right now. And whenever in the past foreign investors have bought, the market has gone up. The trend can reverse at any time. There are no guarantees into the future. But at least this is how I am decoding this information. One of the experts is saying that the spread of COVID-19 of late is less worrying for investors than rising bond yields. For now, India has seen a surge in coronavirus crisis with over 35,000 cases in the last 24 hours. So the daily increase, this has been the highest daily increase since December. Well, that exists, the coronavirus crisis exists, and it is causing the damage it is causing, and the key is foreign investors are not getting stopped. They are jumping in, pumping in more money than last month, and further it's for you to analyze and decide what you want to do with your investments. On this note, guys, could you start typing? What are you getting? What are you learning? What's your takeaway for today? Okay, Hira is saying she knows what recharges me completely. Absolutely, Hira. Yes, I have watched Life of Bollywood Wives, Ridhima. I've done that already. Sapna, you love it too? I'm glad there are Bollywood lovers here with me. Hey, Sonika, warm welcome, Pragati. Yeah, Kavleen, time for some shopping for you. Go for it. Time to invest, Sapna. Sapna, not until you've done the stocks course, okay? Because first you need to complete the course, learn the methodology, and then invest on your own. Okay, FIIs are buying. Market is still falling. Yes, Shivani, that's happening. Bond yield some other time, Namita. Anusha, that's a nice one. Yes, I love Bollywood. Archana, shopping for you too. Yes, Sapna. Looking forward to it then. Yes, looking forward. Okay, guys, so whether you shop, whether you wait, the key is keep building your skills. That's the important part. Financial skill building is the key. Like always, I want to close by saying, if you're getting benefited by Women on Wealth, give back. Give back by adding your friends, your family members into the community, into the courses. Let's make more women financially educated together. I look forward to receiving your confirmations and that of your family and friends. Keep us posted. Take charge, guys. Stay safe. Bye-bye. Loads of love.